Hi, I'm Honey, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a super simple bird in a sunset scene. Let's get started. This is a great watercolor tutorial for beginners because it's deceptively simple. We're only gonna be using three colors, yellow, red, and black. I'm gonna be using New Gamboge, Pearl Red, and Neutral Tint. But you can use any materials that you have on hand. I've listed all the materials in the description below. I'm using Arches 100% watercolor paper, and I've taped it to a hard board. This is a 9x12 inch size. Step 1. With a pencil, I'm drawing the outline of a bird, somewhere in the middle and around 2/3 of the way down from the top of the paper. I'm drawing a branch underneath the bird. Keeping in mind that the size of the branch should be proportional to the size of the bird. So you don't want the bird to be much bigger than the branch, and you don't want the branch to be much bigger than the bird. They have to realistically look like they're part of the same scene. I'm also drawing branches all around the paper. The branches shouldn't be straight, but more crooked, so they look more organic. I usually start with a main branch and then have sub-branches coming out of that main branch. The branches typically start higher and then go lower because of gravity. I'm not drawing all the branches yet, I'm just marking out the main areas. I'll fill out most of them later. Step 2. I'm gonna use my round 12 brush to do a sunset background. You can use the largest brush that you have. This is a gradient wash from a yellow orange to a red orange. I'm gonna start by mixing up some New Gamboge with a lot of water. I'm doing horizontal strokes starting at the very top. Whenever I want the color to be vibrant, I start with dry paper first, and just add water as needed. As we start getting closer to the middle, I start introducing some red, and I'm blending it into the top part. I'm gonna let this dry. So this is dry. Watercolor typically dries lighter than when you first lay it down. I'm not quite happy with how light this is, so I'm gonna add another layer. If you do this, make sure your paper is completely dry before you add another layer. You don't have to do this step if you're happy with the way your wash looks. You can repeat this step as many times as you want. Just make sure your layer is completely dry each time. I'm gonna let this dry again. Step 3, we're gonna paint the bird using the size 2 brush. Make sure your paper is completely dry. Use your black and make a really thick consistency to paint in your bird. Just color in the pencil drawing that you did in the first step. Step 4, we're gonna paint in the branches. Using the same black, we're gonna add some branches, just following some of the pencil lines we did in the beginning. I'm starting with a branch that the bird perches on, and make sure that the feet of the bird lines up on that branch. The branches will also be thicker where they start, and then get thinner as they get to the end. I'm gonna start adding some leaves to the branches using the same black paint. I'm doing some dotting motion with my brush and just making different varied kinds of shapes. It doesn't have to be perfect. You need to be more organic. You don't have to connect every branch to a leaf. You can leave some to the imagination. Some branches are probably too small to see from a distance. And you can let the brain fill up some of that information. I start by following where the branches end and add leaves there, and then fill up around it where it makes sense. I add some branches here and there to connect some of the leaves. I'm picking up a lot of water so I can do some splatters all around, making sure to cover the bird. I'm hitting the brush on the hand that's covering the bird. And there you have it. If you like this video, make sure you click that like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching.